Hello students, this is the second part of rational numbers, and today first of all we will discuss about addition of rational numbers. How can we add two or more than two rational numbers? So students, if the rational numbers are having same denominators, then how can we add them? So students, if we have two rational numbers with the same denominator as p upon q and r upon q, how can we add them? If the denominators are same, then we don't need to add the denominators. We will add only numerators and we will write denominator as it is. Okay students, for this I am taking an example. You can see if we have two numbers 5 upon 7 and 2 upon 7. These are two rational numbers. Students, here you can see denominators are same. So we don't need to add them. We will write 7 as it is, and we will add the numerators. 5 plus 2, 7 upon 7 is the answer. We can cancel out 7 by 7, then the answer is 1. So students, I think you have understood, if the denominators are same of two or more than two rational numbers, then we don't need to add the denominators. We will add only numerators. Okay students, now we'll discuss about those rational numbers having different denominators. If there are two or more than two rational numbers with different denominators, how can we add them? If we have two rational numbers 3 upon 10, we can take it. The first rational number is 3 upon 10 and the another one is 5 upon 12, then how can we add them? Then students, first of all, we will have to take LCM of denominators. So LCM of 10 and 12 is, what is the LCM of 10 and 12? That is 60. Okay students, now we will divide this LCM by the first denominator. When we divide 60 by 10, the result is 6. Now we will multiply the result by the first numerator. Then 6 into 3 is equal to 18. Okay, plus. Now we will divide the LCM by the second denominator. If we divide 60 by 12, then the result is 5, and we will multiply the result by the second numerator. 5 5s are 25. Okay students, and here you can see the denominator is the LCM 60. Now you will add the add them. 5 8 13, 2 1 3 1 4. This is 43 upon 60. This is our answer. So students, I have told you how can we add two or more than two integers having different denominators. Now students, we will discuss about properties of addition of rational numbers. You can see properties of addition of rational numbers. Okay students, so first of all we will discuss about closure property. So students, first of all we will discuss about closure property of addition. If we have two rational numbers and we are adding them, let we have two rational numbers a upon b and c upon d, and we are adding them, then the result, if the result is e upon f, then the result is also a rational number. Again I am telling you, if we have two rational numbers and we are adding them, the result is also a rational number. Okay students, for this we can take an example. Let we have two rational numbers 2 upon 3 and 5 upon 3. We are adding them. When we add them, then the result is 7 upon 3. So students, you can see 7 upon 3 is also a rational number. So this is the closure property. Okay students, now move to the next property. What is that? That is commutative property. Now the students, what is commutative property of addition of rational numbers? students, if we have two rational numbers a upon b and c upon d and we are adding them, the result is same as if we add the reverse, if we add them reversely, if we change their order. Okay students, again you can see a upon b plus c upon d, if we add c upon d and a upon b, the result is same. In the both side you can see only order is changed, order is changed, still answer is same, the result is same. So this is called commutative property. For this we can take an example. Let we have two rational numbers 2 upon 3 and 5 upon 7 and we are adding them. So students, I have told you how can we add two rational numbers. First of all, we will have to take LCM of denominators. What is the LCM of 7 and 3? That is 21. Now we will divide LCM by the first denominator. When we divide 21 by 3, the result is 7, and we will multiply the result by the first numerator. 7 to the 14. Now we will divide 21 by the second denominator, and 21 will be divided by 7, the result is 3. Now we will multiply 5 by 3, then the result is 5 3 is 15. Okay, now we have 14 plus 15 is equal to 29 upon 21. Okay, now we are changing the order. After changing the order, we have 5 upon 7 plus 2 upon 3. Okay students, now you can see what is the LCM of 7 3 is, that is 21. Now we will divide 21 by 7, the result is 3. We will multiply 3 by 5, 3 5s are 15. Now divide 21 by 3, what is the result? 7, 7 2s are 14. And now add them. On adding them, you can see what is the result? 29 upon 21. Both the results are same. So students, this is the commutative property of addition of rational numbers. Okay. Now what is, now students move to the associative property. You can see in the left side, we have made the group of last two rational numbers, and on the right side, we have made the group of first two rational numbers. So grouping is changed, still the result is same. Students, I am telling you, in this, firstly we will add these two rational numbers, then we will add A upon B. And on the right side, firstly we will add first two rational numbers, then we will add E upon F to it. But the result is also same. Okay students, now I am taking an example for this. Let us suppose we have three rational numbers, 2 upon 3, 4 upon 5 and 9 upon 15, and we are adding them. First of all, we will follow the left hand side. We will make the group of last two rational numbers. Okay students, we will make the group of last two numbers. So students, 2 upon 3 plus, we will add 4 upon 5 to 9 upon 15. What is the LCM of 5 and 15? That is 15. Now we will divide 15 by 5. We will have 3, 3, 4, 12. Now we will divide 15 by 15. The result is 1, 9, 1, 9. Okay students, 2 upon 3 plus 12 plus 9 is 21 upon 15. Now cancel out by 21 and 15 by 3. 3 7s are 21, 3 5s are 15. Now we have 2 upon 3 plus 7 upon 5. Now we will add these two rational numbers, 2 upon 3 and 7 upon 5. Okay students, what is the LCM of 5 and 3? That is 15. We will divide 15 by 3. 5 is the result, 5 2s are 10. Now we will divide 15 by 5. 5 3s are 15, 3 7s are 21. Now this is 10 plus 21 is 31 upon 15. Okay, this is the result of left hand side. Now we will move to the right hand side with the same rational numbers. 2 upon 3 plus 4 upon 5 plus 9 upon 15. Now we will make the group of first two rational numbers. What is the LCM of 3 and 5? That is 15. Now we will divide 15 by 3. The result is 5. 5 to the 10. Divide 15 by 5. That the result is 3. 3 4 is 12 plus 9 upon 15. Okay, students. 10 plus 12, if we add them, we have 22 upon 15 plus 9 upon 15. Now you can see the denominators are same. So we don't need to find the LCM of denominators. We will write 15 as it is and we will add numerators 22 and 9. 22 plus 9 is 31 upon 15. So students, we can see the results are same. Left hand side and right hand side both are same. So student, this is the associative property of addition of rational numbers. Now existence of identity. Students, the number when added to another number gives same result is called additive identity or identity of addition. Students, that number is 0. 0 is the identity of addition. If we add any rational number, let we have a rational number p upon q and we are adding it to 0, the result is p upon q. We have same result here, you can see. So students, 0 is the identity of addition. Okay students, now existence of additive inverse. On adding two rational numbers, the result should be additive identity. The result should be 0. If we have a rational number p upon q and we need result 0, so which one should be the next rational number? That should be the minus p upon q. If we add p upon q and minus p upon q, then the result is 0. So students, you can see minus p upon q is the additive inverse of p upon q. We can take some another examples. 2 upon 3 is the additive inverse of minus 2 upon 3. We will have to change the sign only. Minus 2 upon 3 is the additive inverse of 2 upon 3 and 2 upon 3 is the additive inverse of minus 2 upon 3. Minus 3 upon 5 is the additive inverse of 3 upon 5. 2 upon 5 is the additive inverse of minus 2 upon 5. So students, I think you have understood everything. Still you are having any problem, can ask me. Thank you.